6:23 right now. Congress has been in session for 2 months now, with the lawmakers looking at key issues affecting Hawaii, like the Army restructuring and possible downsizing in Hawaii. Your Representative Mark Takai is back in the islands after, what, you arrived at 9 o'clock last night?
9 o'clock, yes. Got back in last night.
Thanks for waking up with us and joining us.
Thank you.
A lot going on this past Congress. Dominated Wednesday, a Senate committee hearings, of course, talking about the authorization for U.S. military action against ISIS. Your thoughts on that process and where we stand right now as a country?
I've always said that the most difficult decision we're going to have to make as a Congress, and in fact as a president, is whether we send troops in harm's way. And the Senate is looking at it right now. We've had a number of hearings already. Next week, Wednesday, the House Armed Services Committee sees the Secretary of Defense and the Chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff. We'll have another opportunity to talk about the details. You know, right now I'm looking at the request, and I have a few questions as to, you know, how broadly worded and how broad the scope is. So we're talking about definitions of particular terms and what specifically the president is asking, but it's going to be a very tough decision for many of us.
For someone who once served, you understand the stresses that it puts on not only the soldier, but also the families.
Absolutely, yeah. Absolutely. I mean, you know, we've had in Hawaii's case a little bit more than 330 people with ties to Hawaii that we've lost in the last 13 years. So yeah. It's a very tough decision.
Sticking on the military, the subject of military, what is the status right now of restructuring into something that obviously not only impacts us financially, because the military is so important to us, but also just as a sense of confidence and comfort that the military is here. Where are we?
Well, you know, the worst case scenario puts it at about 60,000 people, $1.3 billion a year being lost in our economy and in our population. I don't think it's going to be that bad. In fact, we've been hearing some very good things recently, that the numbers, in fact, might be very small. But, you know, we're working hard as a delegation in D.C. to make sure that as much as possible, we keep our eyes on the ball and make sure that we keep supporting the military. You know, and I think the biggest issue that we have facing us right now as it relates to the cuts to the military is sequestration. So we've got to address that as a Congress to make sure that if, in fact, we want to make sure that the cuts don't result, we have to make sure that we take a look at maybe postponing or lifting the sequestration caps.
Switch gears with you in a bit. You participated in a historic event over the weekend, an emotionally packed one as well. What was that like being in Alabama?
You know, it was incredible. You know, we've heard about it for many years, about the challenges that the civil rights movement had and the creation of the Voters' Rights Act in 1965. You know, truly, it was a life-changing moment for me. But one of the things that I take away from it is that despite having 50 years of pretty significant success, having the President of the United States, a black kid from Hawaii, speaking in front of everybody on the bridge that means so much. Mm-hmm. You know, we have our challenges still.
Absolutely.
And I've committed myself to work hard to make sure that we address some of the challenges that we have in terms of the Voting Rights Act being eroded and some other things. You know, one of the items that really pained me in Alabama was hearing the president speak, and at the same time there were drum beats and protests from people coming from Ferguson. So our job's not done yet.
And we saw that last night. It's still very volatile.
Absolutely,
in Ferguson.
Yes.
Okay, I have to wrap things up, but I do know that you're having these Aloha on the Hill gatherings, which is something that you said I need to do. Why did you say that?
Well, you know, I think it's important for us to make sure that people from Hawaii feel welcomed, especially traveling 5,000 miles all the way to Washington, D.C. So I'll say this. Anybody coming to Washington, D.C. to visit our nation's capital, please call us. But on either Thursday or Wednesdays, we have a special event called Aloha on the Hill around 9 o'clock in the morning where people can come together. But we're just, you know, appreciative of people coming into the office and really spending some time with us.
Following the lead of our late and great Senator Daniel Inouye, who
Absolutely.
Always had an open door
yes.
to the people of Hawaii.
Thank you.
Have a good time back in Hawaii, and a safe trip back to D.C.